Yeah, you were.
All right, folks. So this is the part of the show here. We're going to talk a little bit about PvP.
Everybody,
a couple guys here. Crappy's here and all that. You know, throwing his.
He was in the waiting room.
Somewhat casual PvP expert. I've also brought in a buddy of mine from the game, Trick Dacey. He's well known in the PvP community. Even though somebody told me I shouldn't really have him here because he's not really, you know, huge in the fours and fives community. But the guy does know what he's talking about. And I brought him along. And Chill Cat is supposed to be here. I'm hoping he comes back with the issues we had with the stream tonight, you know, live streaming this and everything. I got some messages out to him. Hopefully he comes back and he can join in on with us and all that. But if you guys didn't notice, I posted a video talking about PvP and my opinions and, you know, the trends and how those trends kind of got, you know, pushed and started with PvP and how we got to where we are today because of those things. But, like, right now, it's like, you know, the biggest thing that everybody talks about is the blue immunities issue. The blue immunities and everything has been one of the things that I've, you know, focused on a lot over the years. And I'm curious, you know, with Crappy and Trick here and all that, I mean, I know you guys have your opinions as well. So let's hear them. Let's hear it, Trick.
I think you had to step away for a second.
Yeah, no, I'm here. thanks for putting me on the spot.
Better you than me.
For everybody out there, like, Trick's juggling three kids right now. He just had a baby, so, you know, bear with him.
PvP. I mean, you know, I haven't been around, so.
You've taken like the last month off. You just had a kid, so.
I
don't think anybody's gonna hold that against you.
Well, but, excuse you for not having full 101 gear.
And I get where some people would be like, oh, he shouldn't be there because he's not a fours and fives guy. I was a big fours and fives guy at one point. But with that being said, I was also running under a different name and wasn't doing YouTube. And Soup, you know as well as I do, when you get a name on this, if you jump in any match, you are the number one target.
Oh, yeah.
So with the current state of the focus fire being key and everybody being, you know, DPS, AMs, you know, all of that, it just really isn't practical for me to do fours and fives.
Right. I mean, it is, even with the double PvP award weekend and everything, I'm, you know, just queuing up for fours, you know, just trying to get my win feats done in Bell Rev, get my gear and everything like that. I still had people posting videos up on me.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and I was just like ridiculous. I mean, I'm in there with a sorcery healer, gadget troll, a gadget DPS, and me with atomic, and I'm not using the aura, I'm not cheesing with the aura, and, you know, people are posting videos up on me, you know, saying, you know, talking shit and everything like that. I'm like, dude, it's like, I am rusty as hell.
But yeah, I mean, that's what it is.
So, I mean, GG, you beat me, okay.
it's the same thing. When I took my my 6-month break, well, the first time I took a break, I missed like, what, 10, 11 game updates? Mm-hmm. And I came back to one shots, which weren't there. And then guys were posting me up telling me to get good and everything. It's like, what do you want from me? You know what I mean? It wasn't like this when I left, but it's understandable.
I saw a vid of you, SD, you got posted, and I guess you guys were running like two DPS, a troll, and just one healer, and the other guys are running two healers and stuff. And like, of course, the group with two healers is going to win because, and people are talking trash in the comments and everything, like, oh, fuck SP, he sucks, and GG. And I wanted to comment so bad, but I was like, you know, I'm just going to stay out of it because these people are fucking ass wipes anyway. You know, like, common sense, you know, like, you would have to be such a strong group. I don't know. You would have to be. It's so hard to beat two healers in a fours match.
And it's not impossible to beat two healers in a fours match.
No, but it's hard. Because
we ran into our fair share of groups like that. But when you run into a group of players that PvP daily, you know, and they're used to working together, you know, and, you know, they know, you know, the lunge spam, the roll spam, you know, glitching, you know, the, you know, and, you know, all the little, you know, little tricks and, you know, that, You know, they, well, they call them tricks, but you know, some of it's cheese. They know all that stuff. You know, it's gonna be nearly impossible to be a group like that unless
you
are using all that stuff to your advantage as well.
And I just don't like when people talk trash like that. Yeah. They're like, "Oh, well, we fucking whooped your ass, and you had one healer, and we had two." Like, I mean, come on now. That's
in sports. See, here's the thing, right? Is back in the old days, you could have different setups, and depending, like, because those are the hybrid days, right? So you could have different setups, and depending on the setup you had and the players that you had on your team, you could still do really good. Nowadays, it's one setup is key. If you don't have it, you ain't winning. And that's a big problem with PvP, as far as every single power you're going to use to DPS, what you're going to use to heal, you know, what weapon you're going to use. It's all,
yeah, and
you got to use what's on top.
By setup, you mean specific powers in that group, not just, you know, two
healers, nature, one troll, two DPS hard light, or one hard light, one munition, and you're all using hand blasters. Because, like,
the standard, you know, fives competitive group was always, you know, two healers, a troll, a DPS, and a tank. That's the way it was.
Yeah.
It's the way it was since the launch of this game. If you don't believe me, I've got probably one of the first videos of you know, the standard five setup on my channel. One of the first videos I upload, I think, because that's, you know, with a setup like that. So that was like the standard, you know, five setup from the get-go. But it was always like, and even as they added new powers, it was always, you know, it was, you know, you could have a nature in there. You could have, an electricity in there. You could have a celestial. You could always have like a mix of those healing powers in there. But now it's like, it has to be nature. You know, you have to have at least one nature in that group. And he's got to be in bug form. You have to have, a hard light DPS in there. You know, you have to have like an earth tank in there because, you know, the earth tanks can mitigate damage on another player that's being focus fired. So I mean, it's really frustrating like that because, you know, now if you are a certain power, you know, you are basically, you know, kind of useless for PvP. You know, I mean, if you don't use bug form and all that, you're handicapping your group because you're not getting your power back and stuff. So, yeah, it's really frustrating. You guys still there?
No, we're just listening.
Yeah, we're just listening.
All right, but, you know, Chill's, I think Chill is on his way. He just sent me a message here.
Awesome. But yeah, I mean, even back in the day with the standard setup is correct. But I mean, with the hybrid setups you used to be able to do with attack mods and role-specific gear, you had more variety. You can do some slippery setups. And that was what made it fun. There was nothing too crazy overpowered. But now it's kind of just like, you know, this is your standard DPS. This is your standard healer. It just sucks.
Yeah,
that stinks. I think they need to chop a couple powers down so they're not so OP,
or at least bring all powers into alignment so that, you know, they're each doing the appropriate thing. And Chill,
you know,
I just had Chill in here and he left.
I've been saying this. I've been saying this for forever now. But as far as arenas go, I would like to see AMs completely gone. I would like to see Weapon Mastery completely gone, and I'd like to see the Blues gone, all damage brought down back to around where it was. And then there would be more variety in the weapon, the powers you use, the setup you use. Role-specific gear is necessary. The RPS system has to come back to save it. And it's not just for the old players to be happy and old players to come back, because a lot of the new guys are going to argue, oh, well, PvP is mainly new guys now, and they're used to this and they're used to that. It boils down to actually being able to get your proper counters and play the game on an even level. You know what I mean?
Right. Right. See, I'm...
And these guys don't know even PvP. They just know,
I'm on a fence. I'm on a fence a little bit with the blue immunities because, you know, like, with the state of the game right now, I mean, you know, the blue immunities are needed simply because of the damage that some people are able to do. But at the same time and all that, there's ways to cheese that blue immunity. I mean, you can get farm a blue off of a Fury who's pulse beaming you. You know, I can get a blue off of a Crystal who's shuriken spamming me. And you know, and if I'm like a power like, you know, like Celestial or Munitions, then I can just start into a quick rotation and all that. It's gonna, you know, one shot somebody. You know, if you get a blue. And that's my issue. That's my issue with the blue immunities right there in and of themselves, is that they add a way for people to be able to cheese crap like that.
Absolutely. And I believe at one point, if I'm not mistaken, because I left the fours and fives a long time ago, but at one point, weren't the pets actually getting blue immunities for players?
Yeah. Well, they were getting their own blues.
Yes, and
they were able to block break you. That was the thing.
And if they block broke, then the player would get the blue immunity.
I don't know if the player got the blue or not.
There was something like that going on, because I remember they did one update when then a lot of guys stopped doing fours until they figured out something new. That was something that was going on.
The pets.
I don't think pets should be involved in that at all. I do agree that blues need to be there right now, because the damage on certain powers and certain weapons is ridiculous. I haven't been around in a month, but when I left, the martial arts, just the lunge alone, could hit you for up to 5K on just a hold move. That's kind of ridiculous. You know what I mean?
Yeah, people are also using it to kite now. Of all things.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the thing that cracks me up.
And, you know, when PvP for me was in its prime, you could have the one-handed and do the four-tap flip slash, and if you were getting a good crit, it was like a 500 crit. You know what I mean? So,
yeah,
it is what it is.
I think Chillcat might be here now.
Is that better? You know, can you hear me?
What is it with PvP these days, too?
Yeah, it's a joke.
You may need to turn yourself up just a little bit. You're a little soft.
Oh, we said you're soft, bro.
That's what she said.
Well, let's not do that.
But, like, what's with PvP today, man? You're fighting someone, and they're like, they get low on health, and they just start running away. Like, can't you just die? Can't you just come over here and die? You're gonna respawn. It's okay. Especially, like, I could see if maybe you're in some fours and stuff like that, and you're kiting away. You want to give your healer some time to heal you or something. But when you're doing like 1v1s, and you're gonna run away from the guy, and you like solely queue up in a scrimmage, and you're doing 1v1s right outside the spot, and this dude is about to kill you, and you just start to run away, like, just take the L, man. Just die.
I'll tell you what happened with that. PlayStation 4 and the option to record is one. And the lunge glitch is the other, right? You're about to die, just lunge away, and you're not going to take. And if you do take damage and lose, you're going on YouTube. That's what happened.
You could clearly see you're about to die if you get punched one more time. Just die. Stop running away. Have some honor. Like, that makes you, in my opinion, that makes you look like.
Yeah.
Makes you look like a bitch.
It's like the old Nimbus Yosh saying, you know, that was your boots on.
And you know what, those days were fun and shit, but there was only a few people recording back then, and people used to fight legit, because there was no fear of getting posted. There wasn't that, there was trash talk, but not that much. And it's like me, right? Like, I got known on the game. I was known by the people that knew me on the villain side already, but I got really known when I started doing YouTube. And a lot of these guys have, even new guys, they have names because of YouTube, and they're posting their 1v1s, and they're posting their fours matches and everything like that. But back then, there was a select couple of people that were posting, and everybody else was fighting without a care, straight up. And it was great, because they knew if you lost, whatever, but you weren't going up on YouTube. And that's the big thing now, is YouTube.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, and the funny thing is, too, man, is like, so many people out there, like, they don't understand, you know, like, especially like with me. You know, it's like I had this one guy come at me on my recent video talking about saying that, you know, first of all, he thinks I get paid, you know, to be the, as he put it, the voice of the community, which cracks me up that anybody would say that about me, especially.
No, he just gets free cosmic material and OP items.
No, I don't.
You know what? And let's talk about those OP items that he gets all the time.
No, we're not talking about that. Damn it! Now shut up.
Oh, all right, change the subject real quick.
But I mean, you know, the guy is coming at me saying the only reason why, you know, my YouTube channel is where it's at, which is not huge by any stretch. I mean, there's other big guys out there doing, you know, videos for this game whose channels are bigger than mine, but they're saying the only reason why it's where it's at is because, you know, I'm on, you know, with, you know, been with on the community council or the community roundtable and everything like that. And I'm like, no, I mean, I've been doing this for a while. I'm pretty sure the reason why I'm on the CRT is because of my videos and because of my channel and because of what I've done with the community with my tournaments. Now, you got it backwards, you know, and it took the guy actually going and looking, you know, researching to get himself informed. To notice that, you know, my channel's been around for about 6 years, and literally the very first video I posted on it was a DCUO video.
Yeah. And that's the thing, like, me and you never used to always get along. And one thing I can say from getting to know you and everything else is just go look at your channel. Go look at how far the DC videos date back. You know what I mean? And I'm not gonna lie. People are like, oh, he gets paid to defend the game and everything else like that. And you know, I jumped to the arrow side. I was in a league with you, and I seen it all firsthand. And this is, you know, one of the villains that are known telling you, you know, that's not how it is. So for all the people that think that it really isn't like that.
I wish I got paid. It'd be nice.
I would do some sucking up if I could get paid.
I used to think that too. I mean, if you don't know and you're on the window looking out, you believe the hype, right? Really not how it is.
You know, like when I went on that podcast with you and Godman and all those guys there, I was like, so many people, they misinterpret, being, you know, respectful and stating your, you know, dissenting opinion about something. You know, without, you know, cussing somebody out, they take that as ass kissing anymore these days. On YouTube.
Hey, can you hear me now?
Yes, there you are, chill.
There we go. Okay. There we go.
Fantastic.
These everybody, microphones.
Yeah. Everybody, Chill Cat's here now. If you guys don't know Chill Cat is a poster on the forums. He's also a PC player. But he's been getting some. Don't boo him! Don't boo him! He's one of the good ones.
Come on! Don't do that to me!
He's one of the good ones, but he's also one of the guys though who's been like heavily involved in talking with folks about PvP on the forums, and that's why I wanted to have him on here because he's actually kind of guy in. I don't know. You've actually got a respectful outlook from those other PC guys that we've been talking about a bit. Or at least that I talked about a bit in my video.
Oh, don't punch me up in that group.
Okay, fine. That's fine. you can say that. I mean, one of the things that I try to do, and this is, you know, how do these things always start? These things always start when somebody gets kind of so pissed off enough and in trouble enough that's like, you know what, let's just do something about it. I've been on since almost just right after free to play basically, but hadn't really done much. I mean, I've been in the game, but I haven't really done much with like trying to instigate any kind of change or trying to do anything like that until it was a little over a year ago when we had. No, it wasn't Nature Lives Matter. It was when they did that big blue immunity dust up. It was about July 4th last year.
Oh my God! Yeah.
When that was the kind of the inciting incident that earned me my first and second ban, which is always fun. But at the same time, it was one of those things where, like, dang it, you know what? You know, and it was a comment. I think it was a comment from Spittle, and I think the comment was something along the lines of, "How in the world do you expect us to kind of put the changes and the fixes in that you guys need, that you say that you want, when you can't even agree amongst yourselves what it is that you want. And as much as it was irritating, it was actually a very true statement. And we, as a community, we just gotten so hung up on infighting and disagreement. And the truth of the matter is, when you really dig in and start kind of getting into the weeds and into the facts of mechanics, structure, framework, how things are supposed to function, the sort of the competing sides were really not all that different. There was nuances and maybe a difference of opinion about the order. And that was what that came down to a lot of ways, the order in which ways things needed to be addressed from these sort of competing sides and competing viewpoints. Mm-hmm. But effectively, the end result, I think, for most people was pretty much the same. It was really just a matter of approach and a matter of what was more important and how you would prioritize the changes. And so that's when I kind of started getting into all those, started developing all those threads and pushing that out there and starting sort of little mini round tables with folks on, if you look for hashtag Unite the PvP Players, you'll see all those different threads, each one talking about different subjects, everything from kiting to blue immunity to weapons damage and AM and just kind of all these different subjects. If you go into the PvP forums and you search on that hashtag, you'll see all those threads pop up. And so the idea was not for me to necessarily say, this is what we wanted to do. What I was really trying to do was just say, instead of everybody in all these different groups and sort of these little factions bickering and infighting about what needs to be done, why don't we just kind of listen to each side, pick out where we're all saying the same thing, just maybe saying a different way, and try and summarize and encapsulate it in the way that everybody can say, yeah, I kind of agree with that. And then give that over and let the devs do something with that.
Right.
And hopefully we'll get to a point where we can get some change on that. I think GU56 was helped by that, I believe. From the standpoint of, you know, some of the things that we were talking about in there, you saw that bore out, especially in the testing, when a lot of people, mm-hmm. I remember when we were saying we're going to do GU, I think it was late November, early December, when we said we're going to start making some fixes and some changes, we need everybody to get on the test. And there was a huge push I saw for people to say, get on tests, put up or shut up, stop complaining about things being broken and actually get on and contribute. And that, I think, a lot of that testing feedback, because now people had a bit of a clear of understanding of where they were, they had common ideas, they could start testing against that. And I think I'm hopeful that that helped a little bit. And I think GU56 was a huge step in the right direction. Unfortunately, it's only one step, and it's been a while since we've taken that step. Yeah. I like to see some progress, but that's kind of how things came about.
I'm gonna come back in 2 seconds and touch back on the testing. I have to step away for 2 seconds and I'll be right back.
All right.
Yep.
That and I mean, as much good as did come out of that, there were some new issues came out of that yep. though as well, and not to mention there was a push by, you know, particular players saying that, you know, if you weren't doing the testing that they were doing, then, you know, you weren't really testing and everything. And it became a huge issue for me because, you know, I don't have my core PvP group anymore. You know, it's been several years. It's been a couple of years since then and all that, much less anybody who's, you know, gets on test with me to test those out and all that. So outside of, you know, getting into, first of all, you know, because of what me and Trick were talking about earlier, you know, anybody can record and all that. Well, it's just as easy on PC as it is on the PS4 these days. So, you know, I, you know, went so far as I made a different account. I've got a different tune that I do my PvPing on, you know, that does not have Super Patriot anywhere in its name.
If anybody wants to know that name, just send me a message.
It's Crappy Heels with a Z. That's what.
Oh, Crappy Heels with a Z. That guy's OP. Yeah. Yeah.
And the he and heel eels is just a 3. It's not an E. you know, just. You know,
how about that crappy heels with two E's? I got it right there.
But I mean, you know, so I mean, I would get on there, I would test things out, I would see how certain things were and everything, and you know, I would have my input on it, and then I would look at videos of the, you know, scrimmages that were taking place, and I would, you know, post my opinions about those. But because I wasn't in those groups or in, you know, regular talks with those people, or, you know, constantly involved with those people, myself and many, many others, basically everybody else that was on test that wasn't with those groups, our opinions were considered invalidated by them, because these guys, you know it all.
Are we talking GU, the game update 56, where everybody was testing the weapon damage and whatnot?
Yes.
Okay. I feel like, because I had tried very hard to get on test, and a lot of us had issues where we couldn't get the test server to work.
Right.
I guess there was some files missing. But with that being said, a lot of the people that were putting, I'm not going to mention any names, but a lot of the people that I noticed were posting videos about, okay, this is needs to be brought down, this needs to this and that. I feel like they weren't on there to actually test the damage. I feel like they were on there to practice.
That's what it came off a lot to me, too.
Because there was a lot of stuff that brought over, and then all of a sudden, the same people posting those videos were using certain weapons with certain combos, and they were number one. Right.
I never saw any like videos from those guys of them posting up them all doing them doing a 5v5 with all of them using dual pistols, you know, or all of them using two-hander or anything like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's important. I think it's important to note what did it well. Because I went through those notes pretty carefully, especially for what MEPS put out and several and Locke and some of those guys put out what they were trying to accomplish, and what I think is interesting to note is what they were trying to accomplish with the changes is essentially it's sort of you know, getting the low hanging fruit, and the low hanging fruit is got to get rid of the one shots.
Right.
You got to get rid of the cheese scenarios where somebody was going in spamming rage. And the match was over in 5 seconds. Mm-hmm. Got to get rid of that scenario where somebody was just so overpowered that one combo and it's done. So partly because what we were trying to get to is to get to that place where essentially matches lasted, where matches weren't just about over and done. They required a little bit of feeling each other out, trying to figure out when to counter, trying to figure out when to hit the combo versus not versus block versus everything else in between. And you can't do that with the one shot scenario. So by taking the damage as low as they did, and there was some feedback, I think that was valid. Maybe some of it was biased.
I'm not shouting down any of the feedback those guys gave in regards to, you know, particular weapons or anything like that. In any way whatsoever. And it's like I've tried to make this abundantly clear. All those guys, I've got a lot of respect for those guys with the skill they've got at the game. I really do.
Well, but what I'm trying to get to is what they accomplished with bringing that weapon damage down, so that way essentially the wind shots went away, and I'm very happy about that.
Yeah.
And I think most of the community is very. You're not seeing people like that. See, Scrimby, I'm rage, and I've got 15 skill points, and I just hit my tune 3 days ago. Scrimby, and I'll beat you.
I feel like where they went with a lot of the testing, though, was with the combo, like with Hard Light. There was one combo that everybody did that we knew was overpowered.
Yep.
Got tested, but not every aspect of that power got tested. I feel like with certain weapons, the weapon mastery combos got tested and the long combos got tested, but the little short combos didn't really get tested. And when it came across, I feel like they did get tested. They just all did, like I said, and that brings me back to some people were on there to just practice, because when it came back to what it was, is not the unlimited hard light combo went away, but the grasping hand came back, and that was OP with the shield, right? The long combos with the shield. You know, you weren't really getting those off, but the tab hold though. And it was certain people that were on there giving their feedback that as soon as the update came live, you get into a match with them, and all of a sudden everybody has a shield in their hand. You know what I mean?
And they knew all the cheese. But to defend those guys a little bit,
I will say this though: those guys did constantly and for the longest time until it was adjusted down. They did call out that shield combo, that tap hold combo. They did call that out.
They said some other things too that were a little out of line that also didn't get touched to defend them a little bit on that.
Yeah, I will say that in general, you know, sort of the known groups of players. If there's something that's out of whack, generally speaking, they're pretty good about calling it out. Partly because not only for just calling it out because they feel it's a cheese factor and it screws up their the way they play and their stances and their styles, but also because you know they are about a certain level. I think all the players want balance. I say that in air quotes, you know, balance, like there ever really is such a thing. So whenever they, because they also don't want to counter it against themselves either. So when somebody who they may not run with, brings up something that might be a cheese factor, you know, obviously they want to see that eliminated. They don't want to fall victim to it any more than anybody else does. So of course they're going to call it out. I mean, nothing really stays secret for long if you look hard enough.
Right. See, my issue with that though was the whole thing around, you know, the incident with hand blasters and the fact that it still had an AoE block break. And while you know someone will they'll come out and they'll say shield is still the best weapon to use for PvP. While some of its long combos may do you know a significant amount of damage. I mean, I can get my issue with shield is I can get more damage from doing a 4-tap hold combo than I can get from doing a big scoop combo, weapon mastery combo with it, and. To me, it shouldn't be like that at all. If you can get a big scoop off,
you should be rewarded because that's a long combo.
Yeah, and the main reason why I'm able.
If you can get a big scoop off, you should just delete your account.
big scoop is like Mega Smash. I mean, it's predictable. What? You see it's coming, and if you don't block, I mean, then your ass going to get hit with it. But at the same time, you know, combos like Mega Smash, Big Scoop. You know, and other long combos like that, they hardly do any damage anymore. So there's no reward for the risk in using them.
There should be a huge, and this is where the argument goes back and forth with the new guys and old guys. It's like this, man. If a guy is going to do a mega smash on you, it's all holds. If you don't see that coming, you shouldn't be PvPing. And if a guy gets it off on you because you got block broken by his teammate, It doesn't need to be. That's proper PvP teamwork.
That's good teamwork. But that was the main reason why Mega Smash originally got nerfed.
Right. You know what I mean?
Well, I'm talking about way back in the day because Mega Smash just almost one shot you.
And it should. If you can get a Mega Smash off, it should one shot you. That should be legit.
And that's definitely an area that still needs within weapons damage that still needs some work is this concept of risk versus reward and combo length.
Right.
Length and as far as number of taps or holds that you have to you have to use to get it off and what is the end result of the combo once it finally executes. I mean, when you have a long multi-hole combo. First of all, if you can get that whole combo off, good on you because, you know, I mean, your opponent doesn't know what they're doing. But at the same time, that is such a high-risk combo to pull off. It should, I think, my opinion, should have a little bit more reward for successfully completing it because it is such a high-risk combo because you're so vulnerable to interrupt in the course of trying to execute it in the first place.
Right. And that's where I'm getting at with this whole thing with the issue around, you know, hand blasters with the AoE block break on it. You know, the huge argument about how, you know, it needed to stay to combat, you know, screen blocking. Well, screen blocking's been an issue in this game since day one.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it became a lot more prevalent when Blue Immunities came out and people were using Blue Immunities to recover from getting focus fired rather than kiting. But it became even worse, you know, with the Blue Immunities. But, you know, the fact that, you know, Hand Blasters had the only AoE block break, well, that was automatically going to make Hand Blasters the most dominant weapon for competitive PvP.
And I don't even feel like it became the most dominant weapon until the
cut out, Trey.
Because when
you cut out for a second. You don't feel like it the most dominant until what?
I don't feel like, even with it having being the only weapon with that, I don't feel like it became an epidemic until the one shots. Because then everybody had those and just AoE block broke, and then you had that one rage guy or that one hard light guy DPS, and that would just one shot whoever got block broken. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. But taking it out as a block breaker was the right thing to do.
It was the only power that had it on single target, and I agree with that.
Yeah, it was like that because it was supposed to be taken out, and it wasn't. It was an oversight. It's the only power that does an AoE block break. It wasn't meant to be left in. And if we're talking about balance and trying to make everything not the same, but everything to not allow a particular weapon to have a damage advantage, then the right thing to do is to take it out.
Right. See, and my whole point around that issue was not just because it was the only weapon and all that. You know, they said it was the only weapon that could combat screen blocking. We've been combating screen blocking for years before anybody discovered that hand blasters had the only AoE block break.
Screen blocking is a different story. I mean,
we've been combating that for years, and their argument was so adamant towards keeping it that when the decision was made to remove it, the concession. And this is what annoyed me the most about the concession for removing it was the five tap.
Yeah, the five tap.
Which made getting longer combos off, especially combos that only require taps up until you get that one hold, like the four tap hold for shield right now, which hits like a truck. Those combos would not have been possible if there's people screen blocking or there's people, who are paying attention to screen blocking. I mean, I've gotten, ever since that update came out, when that update first dropped, I was just 7-tapping with shield all over the place in arena matches and in 1v1s because, people were like, okay, well, no, he's going to block break me. He's going to block break me. So, I mean, yeah, if they wanted to get rid of screen blocking, then that's the way to go with it by introducing the 5-tap. But at the same time, now you run the risk of getting hit with these really hard combos as opposed to being able to block them.
Yeah, I didn't much agree with the 5-tap thing.
It was a concession. Who's to say if it's permanent or not? It's because we've only taken that GU56 as that first step. Will it stay that way forever? I don't know.
I feel like that was a big deterrent against the one-handed. I feel like that's the only reason it was introduced, to be honest. That's just my opinion.
I don't
know. But I feel like that was a deterrent against the one-hand spam,
That everybody uses hand blasters anyway, so it's just tap, tap, hold.
Yeah,
so
that was another thing, too, with how it made hand blasters, as much as they argue against it, how it's made hand blasters such a dominant weapon for PvP still is because it doesn't do more than 3 taps, and its hardest hitting combo is a single target, hold combo. After I'm talking about the uppercut. Tap tap hold that's the hold. It only hits one target and it hits hard.
So you're not getting screen blocked by that, and that's what everybody uses.
I would like to see the one handed flip slash be target, and that's a big AoE thing. It used to be, and it was awesome. It also didn't hit for 17K, but I mean,
it'd be nice if they separate some of those PvE and PvP.
The problem with flip slash and a lot of the weapons that are like that is somebody, I remember when we were doing the testing, and I think it was back in January, somebody put out a video. It was inside a scrim. I think it was Star Labs. Somebody was doing a scrim, and they were just demonstrating, and they had two players that were in the quote-unquote 7-meter distance window. And they were just kind of slashing away. And if you look at it from a perspective and just pull back, the distance between the two players is massive. It looks ridiculous.
It's the range of the sorcery circle. If they were standing inside the sorcery circle and you were on the edge, you could hit them with both.
The range is so ridiculous.
Same thing with shield, martial arts. And those combos have to have that range for when you're actually meleeing. Because if you were meleeing, and that combo didn't have range, he would hardly hit anything.
I mean, when people say melee, when they say melee and they think of their mind, what does that mean? That means I'm like in somebody's face, I'm like making physical contact with them. But the truth of the matter is, when they're talking about quote unquote cone damage, which is, you know, how the devs have described it, the cone is big, yeah, really cone, big. I mean, cone, you don't have to be anywhere near.
It's almost like an 80-degree cone that hits anything within 7 meters of the target.
So really, when we're talking about, people keep saying, "Well, I just want single tap, and I want to be single, you know, I want to be single target." Well, to modify that, you'd have to adjust, you'd have to shorten and narrow and decrease the size of the cone for every single tap, for every single tree that exists.
You
would
have to change everything for PvE and PvP, and that
way. They should get on that. It's going to take a lot of work.
Well, I think that they're currently working. But the point is,
that's not an easy ask. Yeah, that's not an easy request when they say just make it single target. That's not it's not an easy thing to do. It's just not.
I don't think bringing PvP back to where everybody as a whole is going to be happy is going to be an easy thing to do now.
No.
Because we have a lot of old players that have lingered around or had just came back, left. And then the majority is going to be new guys that don't know the for the beauty that it was at one point.
Right.
The difficulty is a lot of the things that they've done for PvE, as PvE has evolved over the past 5-ish years, so much of that has kind of just... I'm using a good word, all right? I'm trying to use a nice word. But the point of that, a lot of that has just overflowed into PvP.
Yeah,
without somebody stopping to say, should this be PvE only or not? And a lot of it's just seeped in. And
For instance, Flip Slash used to be single target, but PvE, it got changed
to AoE. I think, like I was saying earlier, you know, the weapon balancing, you know, that's being done right now, is being worked on right now. I think it's going to adjust a lot of things, not just PvE, but PvP related. I mean, we're talking about, like, you know, how big a cone is, you know, how close you have to be for a melee attack to actually hit somebody, like Flip Slash, or, you know, like Big Scoop. I freaking interrupted a block breaker with Big Scoop, and he was well outside the 7 meters on me the other day.
I think they need to be like that, though, for PvE purposes, because even if you were melee and point blank, and it had a very small cone and range on it, he would barely be hitting anything in that group of ads.
Well, no, I'm talking about like, you know, if they're making the adjustments to where you're like, you're within, you know, you're hitting that target within, you're within the 7 meters, you're hitting the target, but the cone is reduced from like the 80 degrees that it seems to be right now, and it's reduced down to, like, you know, at least like 40 to 45.
That would be terrible, though, for PvE purposes, because then what would be the point of doing melee? Because then you would be actually losing damage using a riskier playstyle when you could stand back and hit everything.
But it would make a lot more sense. All right. For PvE,
it wouldn't make sense.
Why should you be one shotting an ad that's 10 meters off to your left, like directly to your left, with Flip Slash? Why should you be doing that?
Like martial arts, same thing, though.
It's not even your target. Same thing.
You know, they all have a range like that. But, like, what I'm saying is, think of this. I'm standing in the back with hand blasters. I could hit everything in front of me. And that's a safe playstyle. Now I'm going up front and I'm playing a riskier playstyle with, say, martial arts, shield, one-handed, something like that. But now my cone is severely reduced, and now I'm only hitting 2-3 things in that group of ads, and now I'm actually losing DPS because I'm only hitting 3 out of the 6-7 ads in the pile. So then it would be like, why would you even use melee if you could, if the cone was so small like that?
What you're doing right there is you're now reproducing the rage mid-range update conversation, because that was that whole bit of angst when the rage update came out, which is saying, well, now you're really, really, really forcing me to be a melee player. Should
the best form of DPS, though.
Shouldn't my high risk, because I have to be in the ads or the boss's face, shouldn't that higher risk be met with a higher level reward? And that's sort of a question mark. I don't have an answer
for
that.
I think so.
I mean, if Britt were on, she'd be the first one to tell you, if I have to be in the boss's face, I damn well better have a higher level of damage to compensate for that.
Yeah. Well, at one point in the game, rage
stuns. So you're getting, the person in the back might only be getting stunned by something. So he's only getting messed up by one thing. But when you're a melee distance, now you're getting those stuns and you're getting countered. So now there's two things working against you, using a riskier playstyle, risking your life too, you know, because the guy in the back is pretty safe. But now you're getting beat up, you're getting countered, you're getting stunned, and the guy in the back is just hanging out.
And I believe at one point in the game, there was a little bit of balance with the range versus melee, because in some instances in the league I was in when I was villain in Red Fist, we had one rage guy that was in the boss's face all day long, and I was nature laying in the back running my poisons with my dual wields. And at the end of the instance, he had a lot more deaths than I did, but the damage was not that far off.
Well, you guys may not remember something, but there was a time in not just PvP but PvE also, where, you know, ranged weapons were doing a lot more damage than melee weapons were.
And they buffed
the damage that the melee weapons are doing. Now, I'm not discounting what you're saying about, you know, how, you know, you should be doing more damage if you're within melee range and all that, especially if you're melee DPSing and all that. But I'm not saying reduce the damage. You know, I mean, what you say, you know, reducing the cone size is going to reduce your damage, but if they buff the damage that weapon's doing, it'll compensate for it. That's what this whole balancing process is about.
It might compensate for it.
See, it should. For the weapon.
You're still not hitting everything, though.
Does that address the problem with, you know, the gadget guy that's running his AM mid-range to melee, or the ice guy that's running his AM mid-range to melee? There's a gray area with that.
You could use so many weapon combos and get that far damage, like, one-handed. Like I said, you have martial arts, one-handed, shield, dual wield. There's others, probably. I just can't really think right now, but a lot of them have that range, and you could backpedal with every single one of them. Martial arts is probably one of the best out of them all for if you are in a group of ads, because Smoke Bomb has a giant AoE on it, and it's 360. It's like an EMP. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, I think that's fine, but maybe in PvP, that stuff should be adjusted, maybe. But for PvE purposes, I think those large cones are needed.
Like I said, we don't know exactly what the weapon balance PvP is, what they're doing in the weapon balance, or how it's going to affect PvP. I just only hope that some of these weapon combos that we know should be hitting hard are going to be hitting hard when the weapon balance comes for PvE and PvP purposes.
Because we talk a lot about cones, but cones aren't the only shape that exists in the game. If we look at GU, I think it was GU60. When they finally got around to giving Celestial its 3-second grace period, one of the big criticisms is that Celestials is so brittle because of the combo reliance to pull off your combos, right? You have to do the combos, but it's so prone to being interrupted. And part of the reason was that is because something about the susceptibility of the attacks when they come in. And it wasn't really a cone shape. It was they changed the cone to a ray for its interrupt window. So there are other shapes besides just cones.
Right.
And so maybe part of that has to go into, you know, looking at the different shapes of the attack vectors and how big they are. And
I think what they actually discovered with Celestial was Celestial was extra susceptible to CC effects. And that's why Celestial was getting interrupted so much.
I would agree with that in PvE.
Combos.
Yeah, I would agree with that in PvE. In PvP, if you interrupted a Celestial once and he was able to get out of it, trying to get another stun or interrupt on them after that while they were running their combos was a whole nother
story. Yeah, it's different in PvP. There was something with the ads in PvE.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, part of that is also talking about counter immunity and blue immunity and how that works too. That is so. What happened after? What happened after 56? After 56, we brought all of the damage down. We took out the power. I didn't do anything. So
we know what you mean.
Yeah, no. Damage came down. Took out the AM. You know, Big Bang. Took out the massive power regeneration to force the players to actually manage their power correctly. And so the kind of leveled that out a little bit, which I think was good. It made the matches last. They weren't these one-shot blowouts. That was an improvement. But what happened as a side effect of that, which wasn't a surprise, I saw a lot of players point that out to say this is going to happen, and it's not a surprise, is any power set that has a healer capability, anything, like Celestial, Sorcery is a big one, Fire, particularly fire tanks, anything with a healing component, were OP.
Right.
Why? Because you know, for two reasons, not just one, two reasons. The first reason is because now you require a lot more effort to get the damage off, and so the rate of health regeneration compared to the amount of damage you can pull off in any given period of time was so now adjusted in the opposite direction that you could heal faster than they could do the damage. That's the one piece. The second piece of it is, especially if you have an individual team that knows how to do counters and know how to farm blues. And so I know some people don't like that phrase, but it is a true phrase, farm blues. Basically, the healers don't have to work as hard if you have a group that knows how to get a blue immunity off, because they're counting so effectively that they're not taking as much damage. So the healers don't have to work as hard to keep the group alive. And so when you combine those two factors, basically healing is a beast. And I'm preaching to the choir. I don't think anybody here would feel differently.
Right, well,
unless you're nature, you know.
Yeah, I think everything's
on was something I was getting ready to comment on, which adds into the other thing that Update 56 did was it removed AMs. It removed the AM mechanic where you got power back by using your AMs in arenas. With the exception of one power, nature, and its
bug needs to be that needs to be taken away.
In its bug form, and it was argued, and it was argued that it needed to stay because of how power, costly nature healing is outside of bug form. Well, my argument is that to that is then don't advocate for an AM that you are opposed to. If you're completely opposed to all AMs being in arenas, then why are you advocating for 1 a.m. to stay in rather than arguing for that power's, power cost to be adjusted instead?
That makes way more sense.
Yeah, it does.
And
I agree 100%.
If you're nature
it makes a lot of sense unless that, nature bug form is using hand blasters.
See, if you run nature human form, and you had a little bit less power cost, and you're in there fighting, I mean, you would be all right, especially with the addition of Harvest. Harvest power cost should definitely be reduced, because you only have to put out your pheromones every 40 seconds-ish. So, like, you could do a lot of healing with Crosspaw or Harvest. Savage Growth uses very little power. You could hit that every once in a while. So if you were actually in there fighting, I know you regen very little bit of power, but with a troll and a little bit reduced power cost, you'd be perfectly fine, just like the rest of the healers. There's no need for power back. I say the same thing all the time, even for PvE. For years, since the game came out, we all healed like men.
We all healed without return. It. I don't want to be a mosquito.
Complained, ever said, oh my god, I use so much power on a bug. No.
Everybody never would get a nature healer in an instance that was good and be like, yes, thank you. And there was no AM.
And we all used human form most of the time. Very rarely did we use bug. And that was before weapon mastery and everything. You just stood in the back and regen your power with hand blasters.
The only time I ever really saw nature use any of its forms in PvP was back when Wolf was freaking broken all to hell.
Or gorilla,
Monkey.
I miss the monkey.
but now every time you go, because I'm pug life, just because it's just the nature of the times that I play. I mean, pretty much, anybody who's nature, I see bugs everywhere.
It's a handicap basically. I know some people are gonna be like, oh, you're you're an asshole or something, but like it really is. It's a handicap for people who sucked with the power.
And the thing is that as an old nature PvPer, I always used human form.
Me too.
I mean, everybody had no problem with it.
You go back and look at any of the old YouTube channels out there and all that. Replacements, my channel, got Brittany's channel. She's got some PvP matches up on hers and all that. All everybody back then. All right, you know, buddy of mine, Beastie Morph from the Replacements on his channel and all that. He used human form in every single PvP match. Nobody used bug form back then. Nobody did. And then the thing is, with Hardlight,
when it got its unlimited combo, if I went into a match as a wolf to even out the score, then I got called an asshole.
So we see, and that's at the time too. Bug form, the only thing you got as a nature healer in bug form, all right, was a 30% increase to the size of your heals. That's
some crit stuff. I mean, it wasn't make or break.
I don't know anything for certain, but I suspect one of the reasons why there wasn't a whole lot of pushback on bug form was because at the time they knew they were going to come back, at least at the time, which I think those plans have changed from what I've seen, because I haven't seen anything crappy. I know this hurts you more than anybody is, because I knew there was this notion that they were going to come back and redo nature anyway for mid range.
2026.
And nice. Right. So in other words, they said, let's just leave it alone for now. And then when we come back to nature for its mid range, which at least at the time that schedule was occurring, I thought would have been done by now, but it maybe not, that there was a notion that it would be coming up. That there was this notion that they were going to come back and address nature anyway in the mid range. And when they did that, they were going to address it in both areas. I don't know that for a fact, but I think that may have been why there wasn't a whole lot of developmental pushback on that, because, you know, let's just leave it, because to dig into it really deep to make the changes they're asking for, we're already going to do when we do the mid-range pass, and the mid-range pass hasn't come about yet, so that's maybe why they left it the way it was.
I'm just saying, when they do make a change to nature, it better be super OP, because I'll just say it. I'm pretty sure we were just supposed to get a hotfix for it on game update 50. Were we not?
Hotfix. We were.
Yeah.
I mean, the cadence was sound. The cadence was you address all the 1, 2, 3, 4s, then you do the weapons update because of the 4 compound powers, and then you address the compound power because the weapons and the AM damage have to be in alignment.
But in game 50, we were supposed to be awesome. Yeah. And then we were under par, and we provided some proof. And then
I'm pretty sure Ice got touched a couple of times. Sorcery got touched a couple of times. Celestia got touched a couple of times. Everything else got touched multiple times.
And no one could ever just go in up the base damage and dot powers. Mm. But this is a dead horse. We're beating a dead horse.
Yeah, that horse is dead.
They are right about that, Chill. The nature and electricity update came out with update 50, and they were supposed both those powers were supposed to get a hot fix after that to align them up properly, and they never did.
When I talk about nature, it makes me want to choke kittens.
I'm just saying, if I have to put out 4 dots in one form, jump to another form, put out 2 more dots, jump to another. I'm pooping on everybody.
9 powers and you didn't even do any damage.
I'd be pooping on everybody.
let me touch on this real quick. With the power back, I don't think any powers should have got power back. I think that was a step in the wrong direction. And I know it was because a lot of people were complaining that, I don't want to be a battery, I don't want to be a battery, blah, blah, blah. But power back is basically a crutch. Now the troll doesn't have to work hard. Now you could run one troll, and it kind of ruins your group comp a little bit. It makes you stack more DPS, and then you could just burn through content quicker, and stuff is less challenging because you could pile in more DPS, and it's less skillful in a way. What I said to do, like me and a whole bunch of other people, And we kind of predicted the future over and over and over with all the changes that they made, but no one ever listens to us. I mean, I'm not saying I'm awesome, but instead of giving everybody power back, just like we mentioned a couple seconds ago, why not just reduce the power cost of stuff? Instead of every time we get new gear, the power cost on our powers is scaling up and up and up. Like, just reduce the power cost of stuff or stop raising the power cost of stuff. And then it won't be such a battle for the trolls, you know, because the trolls are getting more and more bite. So it would be a little bit easier for people to keep up with the power.
All right,
instead of just handing everybody power back and saying, hey, you could just do four DPS alerts because you don't need any power and blah, blah, blah. Like, I'm just not a fan of the easy mode eliminating rolls kind of deal stuff. I would love two trolls in groups so they could work together.
To take what you just said there and lead it back into PvP talking, that's another thing. That's another thing that you know, annoys me with arenas is the power costs in arenas. The power costs have gotten so extreme anymore that it is almost pointless for you as a troller to try to debuff anybody in there, because you're too busy trying to keep power out to the healer who, unless your nature is, you know, costing your group is, you know, it's costing a lot of power to throw heals out. And I that's another thing I don't understand how, Obsidian Chill made this comment on my video. I'm probably going to get the percentages wrong here, but he said before season 3, PvP was about 65% powers and 35% weapons, to whereas now it's 80% combos and 20%, I'm sorry, 80% counters and 20% weapons. You know, they've basically taken the any power usage at all out of arenas, you know, to the point where, like, if you don't, especially if you don't have a controller in your group, you queue into a group, you know, you end up not having a controller in there, you're going to be kind of screwed against a group that does have a controller and a healer in it, because that healer is going to basically out-heal the healer in your group.
I mean, there's always exceptions, there's always different ways to approach it, but basically the pattern that I see over and over again is, say you're in a group, say there's no healer, and you're just DPSing, you're doing whatever you're trying to do. Mm-hmm. And what you do is you go in, you try and you're counting your taps block, roll, block, block, roll, block, counter, block. Save your power for a 35% finisher, move on to the next target.
I mean, and that's pretty much what it's boiled down to. I mean, honestly, thank God the 35%ers are actually killing people in arenas now.
Got people are complaining.
50%ers.
But, yeah, I mean, you know,
they're 45%ers in a lot of games.
Some of them are 50%ers. Yeah, I'll grant you that. But I mean, thank God they're killing people now in arenas. Cause I don't
hard light.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what got me is when people started bitching that they came back. Like, no, bro.
I
like them.
If it wasn't,
they were so necessary back in the day. And it's like, if you bitch that they came back, you're a new dude.
Yeah.
Sorry. And you're a new dude.
But the thing is, though, I mean, without the 35%ers, I mean, how many kills, how many of these four, competitive matches would be going the distance with maybe only, you know, two or three kills. And we're back to the issue that season 3 was supposed to fix. If it wasn't for the 35%ers.
You know, back in the day, I've been in 5 matches with good players, and you would come out 15 minutes and nobody died.
Yeah.
Here's my thing.
It's something that a lot of people forget about how things adjusted and how the community adapted to the way things were before season 3 dropped. Because for the longest time, you could see the change in the trends by the tournaments that I ran at the time. Because for the longest time, I mean, like from the beginning of the game, it was 5v5. 5v5 TDM in the moon. That's where it was at. That's where, you know, it was decided on who was best and who wasn't. That's where it was all decided at. You know, and then we got, you know, we got Watchtower Containment and all that. I mean, even up through the Checkmate days, you know, that it was still all there. And then adjustments started getting made to how much damage we were doing. Caps were being put on our crits in there because newer players and pugs were going into arena matches and they were running into these pre-mates who were maybe they were grinding gear, maybe they were just queuing up just to practice or just, you know, just they were just passing time, but they'd run into these pug groups and they just demolish them.
And it should be like that, though.
I think that's cool.
You know what? I cut my teeth in PvP. I jumped into arena, and I got destroyed. I didn't have gear. I didn't have the skill points right.
I mean, that's the way.
Got demolished.
That's the way some of the best five groups are formed, is by you solo queuing up for a fives or a fours match, getting your ass beat, and going, hey, look, dude, I'm PvPing right now. Do you want to come in here and help me out? Because I can't do it with some of these players that were queuing up, and, you know, and then you pick up another guy, and then another guy, and then another guy. Next thing you know, you had a solid fives group going in there, and every once in a while you'd run these groups, and you'd get a little bit better against them every time.
So I could drop the name of a league. I could drop the name of a league that did exactly that, and they used to get beat all the time, and they ended up being one of the most dangerous DQ.
DQ, yeah.
And they ended up being one of the most known leagues for fives at the time in PvP.
I remember when Dangerous and DQ used to be the biggest jokes on the game when it came to them talking shit in 5v5 chat. But then those guys started getting good. They got good.
And here's the thing, right? Like, I was a member of DQ for a while. And when I joined them, it was after... One sec, darling. Okay, go ahead. And when I joined, it was after it was about being a DPS and being focus fired by the entire team. When people, if I was a healer and I saw a troll, I'm not messing with you. And those leagues before, they weren't very good. Built became very feared, and that's the thing. Like, a lot of guys don't know me for fours and fives. I was around. I was around in the early days. I wasn't.
Let me add this in. So somebody coined this phrase, and I heard it somewhere, and I repeated it because I liked it a lot. And it applies for both PvE and PvP. And the phrase is this: it basically says you can't be hardcore and casual at the same time.
Yeah,
you can't. If you're going to be casual, be casual. You're going to get your butt beat. End of story. Period. If you're going to be hardcore, you're going to put work in, you're going to put time in, you're going to practice, you're going to get good if you're serious about it, if you put the time in, if you invest the time in. The reason I bring that up is because that's what you've seen, and that's kind of what the other side of the argument that, you know, I keep coming back with some of these changes that come in, is they were saying, well, when somebody walks in, they're new, level 10, whatever it is, they go in and they pug in, and they get their butt beat, you're going to scare them off. And they're not going to want to come back.
I don't think
it's going to lower the queue
time. They
like
the game.
Right. But that's exactly the point. The point is, if they're going to be casual, you are going to scare them off. And maybe that's okay. I mean, you know, devs would probably never want to hear anybody say that. But in my opinion, maybe
that could, though, like, yeah. When you play Call of Duty, say you bought Call of Duty right now, you don't have any guns, anything unlocked, and you go in. And you're going to get matched up with people that play Call of Duty every day and have the best stuff. And you're going to get your ass kicked. But, of course, you want to play the game, so you're going to play the game. And then you'll eventually get the stuff that they have. Same thing with this game. You'll eventually get that gear. You'll eventually get more skill points. And you'll eventually get better. You might not be the best of the best, but you'll eventually get better.
Yeah, and that's what I see. That's what I see is a lot of the internal conflict of, you know, how some of the changes have kind of sort of overlapped and conflicted with itself. As I see changes going... You know, Awesome Mechanic is a perfect example. It's a way to give players tools so that they can be casual but play like they're hardcore. And it just makes a mess of things sometimes.
That didn't work.
A lot of people forget this is an MMO.
You're going to have the grind. I didn't get good because I got stuff handed to me.
You can't pick this game up and be as good as somebody who's been playing it, as good or as powerful as somebody who's been playing it for 5 years.
Well, the way it's been like now, you can be, but that's
yeah,
the problem.
I know, but I mean, that's not the way an MMO works. That's not the way.
I think AMs.
Why do you think so many people left this game? Because of AMs, because they, you know, because it took away the grind. It took away the point of the grind. That's why people stopped going after skill points, because AMs took away from the grind. Same thing with PvP. We got these level 10s that are going in now, and all that. Level 10s are getting into the same match as a, you know, with a 101 level 30 in an arena match. And if that guy gets turned off because he got beat by somebody who's got better gear than him, then so be it. So be it. If he gets turned off in PvP, fine. Fine. If it's his first day playing and he expects to go in there and be awesome.
Yeah,
if he can't realize that, you know, he should not have a single chance against somebody who is fully geared, all right, and level 30, you know, if he can't realize that, I don't want him queuing up for PvP. I want people who want to win. All right, I want people who want to earn their wins to queue for PvP. And I think these other guys on the other side of this argument, they feel the same way. Now, as far as like the buff thing is concerned, I'm fine with buffing these guys up. I'm fine with giving them like CR96 for PvP.
Me too. I'm fine with a buff.
Because it equated to the same as the cash gear that we had before.
I would rather cash gear, because then it's physical gear they could put on and they could learn. They could start off learning. Well, I need to get this gear and I need to put this gear on.
This is how I need to mod this gear. This is how I need to, you know, and everything. Mm-hmm.
I would rather you get cash gear than just a free buff. You know, because just getting a buff is, I don't know, that doesn't teach them how to put gear on
back real quick to what I was saying before, though, when I was talking about what led up to season 3 was. They started capping all our damage in that we were doing in arenas because of all these noobs that were getting, you know, steamrolled and everything. So they started capping how much damage we were able to do in there, which that ended up slowing down competitive matches. That's what we were talking about. You know, Dacey was talking about, you know, the matches, you know, you go in there for 15 minutes and nobody died. Well, it's because you'd have, like, these competitive, these good, evenly balanced, you know, equally skilled teams in there. They would know what they were doing. They knew what they were doing. So they knew how to make sure that somebody didn't die, you know, or to go in there, you make sure they didn't give up the kill. And that's what it ended up being. It became more of a survival match than it became a death match with arenas. So that's why when one of the tournaments that I did, I went and said, okay, we're not doing fives. We're going to do fours. We're taking one healer away. We're taking one healer away from the group. And we went in there and people were having fun. They loved fours. They loved fours because they were actually getting kills. Matches were ending within 10 minutes. You know, people were having fun doing it. Okay. And then weapon mastery came along. And all of a sudden people are hitting a lot harder with their weapon mastery combos. Well, then the jump went back to 5v5s. We need that other healer back in here. All right, and even still, with that other healer in there, you were getting definitive winners. If matches went to fit the full 15 minutes, then the score was usually like 800 to 650 or something like that. You know, I mean, there was a definitive winner in there, but people were getting kills. People were dying. All of a sudden, Season 3 comes along. We get the Season 3 announcement, and the main reason why, you know, a lot of the adjustments to the damage and healing and power out was being done to make sure that matches weren't going 15 minutes with nobody dying. Well, that problem had been solved a year ago by the community with their competitive matches, and that was only happening in competitive matches at the time. So it took PvP from being a fast-paced, you know, competitive situation where, like, you know, it's like, oh my god, dude, this guy just got a freaking, you know, combo off on me. I'm about ready to die. I got a kite, or I got to, you know, go and try and get a blue and everything. To this slow, sluggish, no fun, You know, and I'm not looking, you know, to be able to go in and just, like, one-shot anybody. I don't think anybody wants that. I mean, we had a whole update to make sure that one-shots weren't happening anymore because nobody liked them. But at the same time, you know, I want to be able to go into a match and where it's going to be fun, where I'm going to be able to use my powers and not just my weapons, you know, where I'm going to be able to be useful towards the group as a tank, other than just making sure that this guy who's getting targeted is isn't taking as much damage anymore. People want that. And Season 3 took all that away from us, and it made arenas so much like Legends that I got disgusted with it. I mean, Season 3... I mean, the ghosting and the dogging is what got me out of competitive matches, because it was just so rampant and people were doing it all over the place. And it was such an issue on PS3 at the time.
Oh, that put a scar on my PvP-ness back in the day, getting turned into a dog all the time.
Yeah, I mean, that got me out of competitive. That got me out of doing competitive PvP-ing because of that, because of the turn the community took in doing that. But the thing that got me out of competing in PvP was Season 3. That's what did for a lot of the hardcore PvPers that were going on at the time.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah, I didn't know if you guys...
Now you're breaking up.
We all did it. We all did it, man. My first arena match was a nightmare. And if you're not going to go in there and do it, if you were, you would go in and do your legends where you were even and do what you had to do in order to.
You should
figure out your role, you figure out your place, you figure out your team, and you do what you have to do. And PvP was really, really thriving at that time. You want to know the first time I seen Super Patriot? Remember when you had an option to start in PvE or PvP phase?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I started in PvP phase.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was about level 10 when I met Super Patriot. you got to do what you
got
to do. What you got to do. You know what I mean?
I mean, I remember in the beginning remember when the queues worked in the beginning? How did that work? You didn't just queue in and then everybody was just dumped in and they buffed you and they clamped you. They did whatever else. They separated you. You did not queue into a full-on arena with anybody above level 30. They separated pre and post-30s.
Right.
If you were new, but you were below level 30, you were put into your own queue. And everybody who was, you know, everybody who was dumped into Moon trying to carry that stupid rock, and they were all like... They were all like 22 and 24s and 19s, and they were all just stumbling around like a bunch of junior high kids trying to figure stuff out. And even though it was funny because you'd see the difference between, say, a level 10 and a level 25, as an example, was so big as far as terms of experience and knowing how to use power sets and the weapons and everything else. And especially if you created an alt. And that alt was, and you knew how to counter, you knew how to use your weapons, you knew how to kite, you knew how to block roll, you knew how to do all those stuff, and you'd plug into like Moon and surrounded by a bunch of level 12s. It was hilarious to watch them just kind of fumble around, not even know how to use their controllers or even move in the right direction. And you just steamrolled them. I mean, it wasn't a one shot, but I mean, that truly
was
that truly was the difference of experience.
Yeah,
skill as determined by expertise, not skill as in skill points, but skill as in knowing how to do things.
I feel like the guys that cut their teeth on the old PvP and had to work for, yeah, I mean, and this relates to PvE as well, because you had a lot of guys that were on the game strictly for PvP. And you had to do PvE to get yourself beast, because you needed those those skill points.
Yeah,
you needed those skill points.
Everybody ran PvE,
and you had a lot of PvP guys now that are on the game strictly for PvP. They're not legendary.
They're not even premium. Some of them.
They're not even premium.
They don't want to play the other half of the game. They don't want to support the game. They just want to show up in PvP.
And they want to talk trash and class.
Equal to everybody.
You couldn't even get a full set of gear unless you were level 30.
And back in the day, you know what? You had no choice. You had to do what you had to do to get your skill points up, man. Because you were nobody if you didn't have those gear and you didn't have them stacked. And I feel like real PvPers are going to go through that because I went through it. A lot of people I know went through it, and you guys all went through it. You got to get your ass beat to get good.
Somebody who wants to better themselves and be the best they can will do whatever they have to be the best.
If you can't handle going into an arena match and getting steamrolled in order to get that gear, then you don't belong in the arena. And I can remember...
And that's the main issue with the game right now. Because like back in the day, like you were saying, so, we grinded both sides. We grinded both sides, not just because we wanted styles, or anything like that, but because we wanted those feats, we wanted those skill points on it, so we could apply them and use them in PvP. The problem now is, and then at the time too, we were all still learning the game. We were all still playing the game. So it was more a matter of, we were trying to figure out what was the best loadout for us and all that, what, loadouts we should be using in PvP and everything. One of my fondest memories of early competitive fives and all that on this game was people, hassling me and giving me shit because I was PvPing in Tank Stance. And then one of the things I remember them laughing at the most with, a couple of guys I PvP'd with was them getting accused of hacking or cheating in the game because the controllers couldn't keep a debuff on them. Because apparently at the time I was the only guy who read the freaking power descriptions,
how to wash yourself.
I was the only one that read the power descriptions at the time that said that, a burnout and buried determination, they remove debuffs from fellow group members.
Mm-hmm.
I was the only one that apparently knew that at the time. And so, my healers are getting accused of hacking or cheating and everything. Everybody's laughing at me and, for running a Tank Stance, but we were winning every damn match. And it's because, I learned the power. Now, I'm a member of several Facebook groups for DCUO for his game. And there's not a day that goes by that I don't see, a comment on there. Hey, what's the best DPS power for PvP right now? Or what's the best DPS power for this? What's a good loadout to use for PvP and everything? People aren't willing to figure this shit out on their own anymore. They're wanting to go to other people, find this stuff out, and what they're looking for, what they're wanting to find, is what's the cheese? What's the cheese that can be used in PvP right now? What's the cheese that can be used?
And that's what it is. One of the funniest things is the 1v1ers that I'm going to talk about now. And it's like, you could be a healer or you could be a DPS or a troll nowadays. Go up against a fire tank. If they half know what they're doing, you're not going to win the match, And guys back in the day, some guys that claim to be old school players would be like, if you ran into a fire tank or a tank back in the day, you were going to lose anyway. If you're from the RPS system.
Yeah,
that's not the case, buddy. Because if you were a healer and you ran into a tank, it's game over.
As a tank power player myself, I cannot tell you how many ice tanks I swooped to death in lair battles. Because they were in there with their regenerative shielding mod, with the tactical mods and everything too. They were in there with the regenerative shielding mod, thinking that they were just going to dominate that. And then one swoop, man, their shields are gone, their toughness, but their buff is gone, and all that. And now they're just a soft hitting DPS.
Yeah,
I'm basically going to say the same thing that you said. I mean, when I was really, at the peak of my PvP time, my main is ice, but it wasn't with it was actually my hard light tune. But this was when RPS was still in place. The best matches ever is because I would switch back and forth between DPS and troll is when I'd plug into something like the pit and there's some new sorcery guy that's just hanging out in the middle of space up in the air, and I would hunt him like a cat on a mouse, chasing him, and he's running circles trying to get away from me. And now I would just hunt him down, and then healing's gone, the group falls, and then it would drive me nuts because I'd queue in as DPS, because it was another troller, and he wasn't chasing down the healer. I'm like, you're a troller. Chase that healer. Get him, debuff him, chase him down.
Yeah.
And then he wouldn't, and then I'd wait till I wipe, and then I'd switch over and chase
him down. I can't tell you enough how that's much I used to love. Fun. I used to love queuing in as a nature healer, DPS spec, DPS gear, and getting queued up against a tank. See, because it was savage. Let me have some fun with you.
Yeah, that's something a lot of players, you know, they forget about. I mean, all the guys that back in the day who, they used to call me like they would call me a noob or a scrub and all that because I was using the movement mode debuffs on them if they went into a lair match against me as a healer, and all that. I just brushed it off because I took your shield off, I took your healing buff off. But, you still got a roll advantage over me. You're still hitting me harder. You're hitting me harder than I'm hitting you for in DPS stance. I mean, that's why everybody out there who hated the movement mode debuffs, I can see where your point of view is, but I don't agree with you simply because the roll advantage was still there. Healers were hitting tank powers so hard back then.
Oh, yeah.
I just want RPS back.
Yeah,
I do. I'm for the RPS, man.
I want a complete reset on season 3. I want everything back to the way PvP was before season 3. Even with the damn blue immunities, I'll suck it up with the blue immunities.
Just bring back it would have been Android.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people talk about checkmate days and everything like that. I'm fine.
Checkmate,
I'm fine.
Android.
The one problem with RPS was it's a disadvantage in 1v1.
And you know what? I agree. I agree with you 100%. One of the solutions
the movement mode debuffs balance that out, though. In 1v1s and 2v2s, the movement mode debuffs balance that out.
That's true.
I don't disagree with you. I don't disagree.
What my solution to that problem would have been in 1v1s, when you queue, you automatically queue as DPS. Just take the rules out of 1v1 completely.
You're going to have the people out there that are going to be saying, oh, you're forcing me to play a way I don't want to play. And, and like that. And as much as, I see exactly where you're coming from. I'm just pointing out where the issues are going to be now. And, and to be completely honest with you, back in the day, but even back then, I kind of liked queuing up for twos with a healer. I kind of liked queuing up for layer battles with twos.
I've queued twos matches where it's me and another healer and you run into two trolls. Well,
yeah. The other way to look at it is,
can you not have RPS in 1v1 and 2v2. Only fours or higher.
I think the RPS system should be in ones through eights. I feel it should be in ones through eights. Like I said before, the movement mode debuffs, they balance things out.
I could get behind the movement modes in ones. At the very least, that would improve it.
That's what I'm saying.
That would fix a lot. Because even if you did have a movement debuff and you ran into a fire tank, you had something to stand on.
These are my ideas here. I want to see what you guys' opinions are. These are, and then we need to wrap this up because we could go all night. But these are my ideas on what the next season for PvP should be as far as mechanics, aside from minor adjustments to, like weapons and everything like that. Obviously, I would love to see every weapon be a viable weapon for arenas. I would love to see that. I'd like to see every healing tank and controlling power and DPS power be comparable to each other, or at least complement each other in some ways. But as far as the overall gist of things and all, the way I want, I mean, obviously, I want to see the RPS system come back. RPS system needs to come back with roll gear. All right, I want to be able to mod and get affinity bonuses for those mods, for R&D mods. No tactical mods. I'm not asking for tactical mods. I would like to see utility
buffs. What do you mean by affinity mods? Be specific.
Well, like, okay, when you put a blue mod in a blue socket, you get an affinity bonus.
That would follow the RPS system. Yeah, I agree with that.
Okay.
Right. So I would like to see our utility belts come back. Not so we can use PvE, things that we get from PvE in them, but that we can actually purchase PvE equivalents of items from a PvP vendor with PvP marks. So if you want a damage buff trinket, there's a damage buff trinket for PvP. You know, there's a healing buff trinket for PvP. Obviously, you know, your breakout trinket. If you want to have, you know, bring some consumables back in. Consumables
I got that debuff grenade plan burning a hole in my pocket. Right there.
You're not the only one.
Bring some of the consumables back. I mean, I'm not talking about the debuff grenade, but I'm talking about like the PI ones, the PI consumables. Maybe you know, not ones that you can get from PvE, but PvP comparable ones that you can purchase with PvP marks. This would give us a mark sync into PvP, which would keep people PvPing once they've got their gear and their weapons. Keep up with the mods, with the prefab mobs. You know, you don't want to farm to mod your gear, then here's these prefab. And we had those six experts prefab mods on that vendor. You know, and they were the best mods to to get at the time. I mean, that was the only place you could get a two-stat mod. That was the only place you could get a Vit and Precision mod. You know, if you didn't want to make the mod yourself from R&D. But, you know, keep up with that. You know, keep those up to date. I mean, those are the main things. I mean, I'd almost be happy with keeping blue immunities in if we could have things back to the way they were. I mean, you know, no more stat caps. No stat caps on players, right?
Okay, wait a minute. You're glossing that over too quick. So,
okay.
Because I know we got to wrap it up, but that blue immunity question, that's a big question. So the a lot of the conversation, because we'll go back to, you know, when I first joined up and how I got involved, and a lot of the conversations from multiple camps, and the consensus, to my understanding, is if you fix the damage, you fix a lot of the kind of the cheese stuff, the one shot stuff, there's a pretty reasonable degree of agreement that blue immunity is no longer necessary.
Oh, absolutely. I completely agree with that. I completely agree with that.
Blue immunity essentially was your counter response to one-shot counters.
No.
I'm not saying that's why it was implemented. I'm saying that's what it had turned into.
Yeah.
That's what it had turned into. And so that dust up that I mentioned at the very beginning, coming back to July, that was a lot of the crux of the concern. They said, well, that's the only thing we have to protect ourselves against, the one shots. You take that away right now, we have no protection against the one shots and we're screwed. And that's kind of that's a lot of that argument. It's not all of it, but that's where a good chunk of that is.
Yeah, and my argument against that argument at the time was that, you know, the removal of blue immunities they did on the test server, right? First of all, it was just on the test server. It wasn't going on in the game. All right, and I was not advocating for the blue immunities to go immediately on, removal of them to go immediately on the game with everybody getting one shot out there. It was the first step. It wasn't the first step that some people wanted to take, but it was the first step, and then steps could have been taken after that. You know, you deal with the issue of completely removing blue immunities. You see where the issues arise from that, all right, and then you make adjustments, and then you go into, then you deal, you know, which would have included dealing with the one shots. That was the thing that everybody back then that was so against the removal of blue immunities were ignoring. They were completely ignoring it. All right. It was a step. It wasn't the first step they would have taken, but it was a first step. We had the devs' ears. We had the devs' ears at the time, but simply because it wasn't their first step, it wasn't on their terms. And all that, they threw their, you know, I mean, I got banned a few times myself during that period.
Again, I think a lot of that comes a lot of
making the argument.
A lot of that comes back to it's not. I think ultimately all the groups kind of want to get to the same place. The main crux of the argument was really about the approach, the order, the priority of how you got there. So, 56 in particular, I think, has kind of flipped that a little bit because the devs have certainly taken a different approach than what they were trying to do last July. But, I mean, kind of where I'm at personally, this is my opinion, I'm not saying anybody should do this, this is how I feel, is if the primary argument at that time was you needed blue immunity because that was your protection against the one-shot cheese is gone. It's definitely not being used for what was originally intended, which was to be a sort of a helper for the new player coming in so they have a fighting chance. It's definitely been adapted in a way that was definitely not intended. And at this point, unless somebody can point out something glaring that I'm not seeing, there's no reason for it to still be there.
Yeah, I mean, if damage is down, which, I mean, we've all seen it in arenas lately, since 56... you know, how much damage is down in arenas and all that, then I see no point in them remaining either. Granted, there are some outliers out there with certain, you know, like powers, you know, that are, you know, still hitting, you know, too hard. But that could be, that's something that could be addressed for the next season. And if those things are addressed, and I see absolutely no reason for the counter immunities, I'm sorry, for the blue immunities to remain. I would almost be willing to say that if you wanted to look for to keep a counter immunity in there in regards to the blues, I would almost be fine with that. But as far as the damage immunity, it needs to go. It needs to go.
Yeah, I mean, if anything, the complaint I keep hearing over and over again, I mean, there's more than one complaint, obviously. There's always more than one complaint. But the complaint I always hear over and over again is now that with that damage reduced as much as it has been, now the matches are too long almost.
Yeah.
They're almost too slow, especially when you get experienced groups, teams that have some synergy, that have some chemistry, that know how to work together, and you get them. I've seen videos, you know, I've even participated in a few where trick I even pointed out earlier is you'll have a 15-minute match and there isn't one death.
Yeah.
Because all they're doing is basically locked in this grapple hold of counters and blues and healers just sitting on the periphery, nobody touching them because everybody's afraid to move. It's just basically this 15-minute ball of tension.
Yeah,
somebody's just trying to figure out who can get who's going to make the first mistake, who's not going to get the counter off right.
Yeah,
it's mind-numbing.
It becomes more of a survival mode match instead of a team death match.
That's PvP.
Listen, why don't they just take out counters and blues and just let everybody go at it?
You know, what I would really like is I would like to see them focus strictly in whatever developer plays the game to test every weapon and every weapon. As long as always should do equal damage to the other weapon as long as their combo is. RPS needs to come back. I would like to see people be afraid of somebody else in a PvP match. That's the main thing, is nobody's afraid of nobody, you know.
You're breaking up, Trick.
Yeah, you're breaking up, bad Trick.
Am I? Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, like nobody's afraid of each other in PvP anymore. You know? If I'm a troll, I'm not going to lock up with a tank. But you see that all the time.
Oh, yeah.
It's just, I don't know, man. They need to make some serious adjustments. Have they done the weapon pass yet?
Nope.
I believe if they can equal out all weapons, give people the variety to use. I'd like to see some DPSs using dual pistols. You know, I don't want to see all DPSs using martial arts, hand blasters. You know, RPS needs to definitely come back. And I mean, it's hard to say. Like, it really depends. Like, we got the old players that know what it was like and the new players that don't. And you got those guys arguing about blues. Bring the damage down even more because certain things are still OP. Bring that damage down.
I'd rather see those things that are OP adjusted down, but our caps weren't completely removed.
So yeah, the argument being made
right now on the forums is your skill points do still matter and all that. You're not going to reach the cap on certain stats and everything.
I don't think there should be any cap.
But
there shouldn't be a cap.
There's still a cap on how much my crit damage is doing. You know, there's still
because cap, then you have guys that don't have as much. They know what the cap is and they know how to hit it, and then they're specking for other things to make themselves more powerful than the guy with more skill points. Like it shouldn't be like
that. And maybe it would encourage those guys, if there was no cap, to go get the rest of those skill points.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Go run your content.
I think it was Bryce Allen or somebody who put the stats out there for the 101 gear.
Right.
And I think if I remember correctly, I mean, with basically just doing the gear without any modding or any effort at all, you're already capped at crit damage. You can still, without adding any of the skill points into the trees.
Yeah,
so adding in the skill points into crit damage slots is a waste of time. Now, the crit chance slots are, you know, yeah, those will boost you up. Yeah. You can work those up. But the amount of crit damage you can do is just so low right now that just by adding a gear without modding or doing anything special or even not really having any skill points, you're already maxed out.
Yeah.
I mean, now, the magnitudes as far as PvP, they mean absolutely nothing. Last time I checked.
They don't. You know, but I mean, but removing all caps. I mean, if a tank, if a tank shield can mitigate 100 damage, that's fine. That's what the RPS system's for. You get a healer on his ass.
Exactly.
You get a healer on his ass, and that healer's going to kill that tank.
Exactly.
You know? I'm really big on stats and not taking stuff away from somebody who has put in the time and earned their stuff.
Just that's what it boils down to.
Does not have the skill points, somebody else does. I don't care if you're going to buff that person up a little bit or whatever, but I don't think it's ever right to take away anything anybody has earned.
I don't even believe it to be buffed because look at old Fight Club.
And that's Soup, you'll know especially.
Yeah.
Look at the old Fight Club and look at some of the names. I'm not going to mention any of them, but look at some of the names that were out there and then look at the same names that we used to queue in against.
Those kids would all get destroyed.
They were not the same names when you would see outside to inside.
Destroyed. We wouldn't hear any shit talking from any of those kids.
So that brings us to
all of a sudden those kids are on the other side of the fence, and it shouldn't be like that. You should have to go in. You should have to do what we did. You should have to get your ass beat. You should have to put in that grind time on the PVE side of things as well, and get where we are.
And that kind of leads us into the second structural problem. So the first one in my mind, that's kind of the most immediate one, is a yes or no, is that blue immunity question. Again, I'm not 100% saying that there's no room for discussion on that, but to my mind, there's no reason for it to be there. It needs to come out. The second one needs to come out. Yeah, the second one is about the stat cap. Mm-hmm. And so we've had this discussion, Soups, and it's probably one of the reasons why you asked me on that. Is it pay to win?
I don't feel it is.
Is the stat cap pay to win? Here's why I've heard the argument. I'm not saying I agree with it. But it's structurally, this is why people can say that. It is because to get those extra skill points to give you the extra stats that you need, that means you have to buy the content. So that means if you're a legendary member, you automatically have an advantage.
Here's my counter to that argument, though. Okay, those people out there who say this is a pay to win game, if it makes it so that all skill points that you get matter towards PvP. My argument to you is this is not Injustice. This is not Tekken. This is not Street Fighter. This is an MMO.
Mm-hmm.
All right? The grind is, grind the, to grind get the is best part stuff. Of every MMO out there. Yeah, sure, you can go look at games like WoW, who, have a, you can buy a hero character or something like that that's already level 85 or something or whatever. Okay? But it's still an MMO. Now, there's other arguments about like games like Guild Wars 2 and all that who don't, have, any PvP gear. Everybody's at the same stats and all that. Well, guess what? We've got Legends.
Yep.
If you're looking for that, we've got Legends.
By taking the grind and listening to all the people who want things equal and easier is the reason the game is in the position it is today.
Yeah.
By trying to do that stuff. When the game first came out and it was different and unique and everybody had to work for everything and it made you a better player by working for everything, it was a much better game.
And here's my other thing. Can't be casual and hardcore at the same time.
My definition of pay to win is not having to get your subscription to run the content and actually work to get the feats with a good team, play your role, and get the skill points and get better. My definition of pay to win is, oh, Rage just got buffed. Let me drop $10 on a power token. Now I'm beast.
Right, and now
that's pay to win.
Here's what I'm going to say about this, and we're going to have to wrap this up because I just saw what time it is. here's the thing I'm going to say about it. I mean, if them making stats matter in PvP, like they're going to be making in PvE, all right, where we're not going to be capped at all, if that, all right, makes some of these kids who don't have 150 skill points, who, you know, only get on this game to PvP, if it makes some of these people, some of these players, not just the kids, but some of the adults, too, who don't want to do any PvE at all, if it makes any of those players not want to play this game, it's no loss to this game whatsoever because they weren't supporting it to begin with.
Yep, they don't contribute anything to the game but trash talking anyway, so it doesn't matter.
It's like this. All the original guys that posting videos and promoting the game all put their time in and work to get where they were in order to make themselves known to do that.
And it made
these new guys aren't doing that. These new guys are not doing that at all. And if they're gone, you know what? There'll be other players that are coming into the game behind them.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I think it really comes back to how you would balance it. So, you know, to the most, I would say, vocal players right now that are kind of talking about this issue that have kind of differing opinions would be something like either Ventus versus like a Horus, like a Dark Horus, right? So those guys and the one is saying, well, my gear and my stats, I should be able to pummel somebody if I have the gear and the stats. And then on the other hand, you got somebody like Horus who says, you know, take all my gear and stats away, my skills should determine whether or not a pummel guy. So they're not too far off. Why not both? And that's the point is I'd be okay with taking the caps off personally, but it can't be taken off. And then the effect of those stats can't be so high that because I'm over 200, that I'm obliterating somebody who's like 150.
I believe it
can't be that extreme.
I believe it shouldn't be that extreme, but I believe they should balance the queues.
I believe it can be extreme. I mean, for the people who are super competitive, let it be extreme. Have two types of lobbies. You could have a lobby with level and skill point advantages enabled, and then you could have your casual arenas where none of that stuff
better,
is really
even
enabled.
Even better. What you could do is you could separate, and this is something that could persist over every single season. This would be something that persists over every single season. You can separate the queues between casual and hardcore. All right. The only way you can get into a hardcore queue, and granted, this will divide
the
community.
Is if you queue up for it?
No, the only way is if you queue up for it, and if you have the top, if you got the top end gear, then there's no issues with people, you know, complaining about it's like, oh, he's got more gear than me, and all that. No, if he's got the same amount of gear as you, if it comes then it just comes down to skill points and skill, and all that. It shouldn't be an issue. It should not be an issue. All right, but everybody before that, while you're gearing up, for everybody who's gearing up their characters and all that, that's what the other queue system's for.
Yeah, just have a playlist where stats matter.
I feel like the
difference between the CR levels and the current gear set is not huge.
No, it's not that much.
Like, on my main right now, I'm grinding up because I usually don't use my main for PvP. I've been using alts, but I decided to bring my main up, and I went into a lair battle. Just it was yesterday, the day before, and on my main it was like 90. I'm like 97 and a half, almost 98, and against another ice guy and full 100 plus, almost on his way to 101, and it was close. It was like a 2-3. I mean, I lost it, but it was close. So the you know, the stat advantage between the two is probably what made the difference, but it was a little advantage. It wasn't a big one. And that's what folks got to get it in their head, is that the amount of stat change between 97 versus 98 versus 99 versus 100 is not huge. If you're getting royally beat, it's not because of the gear. It's just not. It's
because of your skill level.
It does have a lot. It does have a lot to do.
It has an
effect. I played on my full one before the update, my full 100 tune versus a new tune. And skill has a lot to play with it, but you do notice the damage difference and everything like that, big time.
Especially now with 101 gear. But like, if you're in 98 and 99, it's not that big of a
thing. And I feel like this, and this works to PvP and PvE. I feel like the new guys coming in don't want to work because they don't have to work, because they're going to be put on at least a decent playing field with the experienced guys. It's kind of like a gimme in golf. And I feel like the experienced guys who were putting in their work, they really don't want to put in work anymore, because it's like, it doesn't matter anyway. There's CR differential in PvE, and in PvP, you know, it's whatever. You know, I'm going to be balanced out and capped regardless, so why even try to progress how I was for those four or five years I've been on the game?
It's like the difference between, you know, you hitting from the, you know, the blue tee, and, you know, them hitting from the woman's tee, and them bragging about because they're getting birdies.
It just puts everybody in this thing where it's like, you know, let's not even worry about playing the game, and let's just complain about everything else. It's just nobody's working anymore. And there really isn't a much. There's no reward for working anymore.
It's the same thing again. You can't be casual and a hardcore at the same time. The game, a lot of those design changes that have been made to the game is trying to set up casual new players to basically be hardcore right out of the game.
And that's the real thing. You got your hardcore guys that are on this power, and your hardcore guys that are on that power, and then you got your new guy that comes in on this power, and he's still hardcore, and he plays every weekend, and they come into a DPS battle, PvP or PvE, and they're doing the same thing. And that ain't right.
I don't think you should just show up and be able to be almost the best.
None of us did.
I mean, philosophically, I think that has to be prioritized, is we have to take out the mechanisms that let casual players be hardcore. We have to take out those mechanisms and let people become hardcore through work, through practice,
you need to
through
learn.
Training, through effort.
Yep. The noob, or the people who we consider noobs from back in the day before game update 36, if you want to say, the noobs that were back in the day would crush the noobs that we have today.
Oh, man. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Because there was more learning going on back in the day, and
you want those noobs in your group now.
People were more interested in trying to figure stuff out than they were today, because everything, like when you go into Legends PvE, people that basically don't PvP have no clue how to do Legends PvE, because they don't know how to use weapon combos, because they just go in there and they're ice and they press one button PvE, or they go 1, 2, 3, 4, and like, you're like looking at these people like you don't even know how to clip weapon attacks or do full weapon combos, and that's sad.
Yeah,
it's sad. I mean, that weapons got eliminated.
I mean, crappy. Me and you had to make that one point that one time in the Legends PvE when guys were complaining that an instance needed a nerf, and then we went and two-manned it.
Yeah.
I remember that night. That was funny.
I mean, we died a couple times, but we were trying to use the characters that we liked. You know what I mean? And it was a little rough. I was using Black Adam, and he's just not the best. And then we changed it up, and like, I think Daisy was, what were you, Robin?
Yeah, I was Robin.
Flash, and we tore that shit up.
Yeah.
Yeah, Robin is OP. Don't laugh at Robin.
Yeah, no, Robin is Robin
can do some serious damage in Legends PvE, man.
Robin's the truth.
And the Flash does crazy damage, too, man, if you know how to play him. Your combo and his powers, right? And
but I mean, with that freaky little like if you OP have four block break or teleport thing?
Nah, I didn't even use that in like PvE Legends. That's like, that doesn't even
play. He uses that to get to the targets faster to put in that DPS.
Disorienting, right? I mean, it happens so fast. It's almost confusing because it happens so fast. You're kind of not used to it.
In PvP, that was a good tactic, I guess, if you want to cheese something. But like in PvE Legends, that was totally not the way to go.
But, hey, we're going to wrap this up, guys. As much as I would love to sit here and talk, I love sitting here and talking about this game, and I tell that from you guys as well. I especially love talking about PvP.
We need to get rid of the noobish stuff. But let me say one more thing.
Go ahead.
I think PvE DPS, all these AMs, all the easy mode stuff, ice, how you push one button, stuff like that should be entry level DPS. Like,
yeah, thank you.
And you do that, and it does good damage, but it does not do the damage you could do with a regular loadout or rotation that we used to do back in the day. Something more complex. You know, a 1-2-3 reload out is mind-numbingly dumb and easy and should not do what it does. You know, like when Ice first came out with its AM and you could just press one button, it didn't do crazy damage. I thought it was at the right level because a Weapon Mastery loadout did more damage than that, and Weapon Mastery takes a little bit more skill. You have to have good timing for the Weapon Mastery to be super effective. And then you had that stupid ice AM where you press one button and it did less damage. And I think that's the way it should have been.
Yeah, all AM should be entry level.
Speaking as an ice guy, you know what I miss? I miss supercharges.
Oh, I miss supercharges. Oh, you got a supercharge. I don't want to hear nothing about you. You're broken at a supercharge over there.
We do. But I remember putting in like, you know, Ice Golem and doing all those other things, and that was kind of fun because you would kind of line it up, wait for the boss to get to like 35% or lower, and then trying to hit them, and then you turn into the ice giant and do all those kinds of things. Because of the rotation the way it is, it's the prescribed 405. You have one extra slot and that's it. And if you're outside of that, I mean, you're not maximizing yourself in your group. And they're like, how come your damage is low? And it's like,
and the thing is, with AMs, there's no room for improvement with AMs. Like, you're standing next to a guy going 1-2-3, and you're going 1-2-3. You really can't be too much better than that guy because you're both just going 1-2-3. There's no like skill gap, and it's lazy and stupid. The only way you could separate yourself is if you run to the ads faster than the other guy.
The only variety is where you stand.
Mm-hmm. And I gotta be honest, man.
DPS competition sickening me now.
I hate the mid-range and balance stuff because all it does is encourage people to stand as close to stuff as they possibly can to get the most damage, and then everybody's dying a lot. When you're trying to heal everybody, then I have to work harder because all the dummies are standing right in front of the bosses all the time. Like,
and especially as when I'm tanking, the most annoying
thing. Everybody's standing
around you. Get away from me.
And you can't even move. If you have to move, good luck.
See, me, I miss a real man supercharge like Fireball Barrage. But I want to leave the crappy and all that, leave a PvE bookend on a PvE conversation.
Damn it, crappy.
Grinding. It just stems into the people being lazy and just wanting everything handed to them. When you start listening to those people, you get the game and the condition it is in today with all these easy mode stuff, and it creates a bad player base because no one's interested in learning.
We're going to go ahead and wrap this up, guys, just to get late here. For everybody out there who is still listening, first of all, I want to thank you for that. All right, and if you are still listening and you're watching this video, put a hashtag make PvP great again in the comments section.
All right? Hashtag make major great again. Lives matter.
That way we know if you listen to the entire thing. But this is, of course, the DCO Sourcecast. I want to thank Chillcat and Trick Daisy for stopping by this week, tonight. Trick, especially there, juggling three kids to join us on the conversation. Chill, especially
for your
mediator's grace on the forums that you've shown us the past year. This, of course, is the DCO Sourcecast. You can find us at facebook.com/the DCO Sourcecast. You can also find us on the Twitter at the DCO Sourcecast. And you can find the audio version of the DCO Sourcecast on trekslate.com. Crappy, where can we find you at?
Just Google some crappy heels.
Find him in the kitchen making a sandwich.
Right? Pizza. YouTube crappy heels.
YouTube crappy heels.
Crappy heels.
Yeah. How do you spell that?
like you would spell it, Crappy Heels. Okay. No Z's, no double E's. I don't know who those people are.
Let's see. And you can, of course, you can find me at youtube.com/thedaddysalsa. I'm also on facebook.com/thedaddysalsa. The Twitter at thedaddysalsa there. And you can find me and the DCO Sourcecast here at twitch.tv/thedaddysalsa. Once again, I want to thank Chillcat and Trick Daisy for coming out tonight and talking some PvP with us. I want to thank Crappy here for being my co-host. And until next week, though, guys, y'all take care. Take care. Bye.
Peace. Bye. Nature lives matter.
Hashtag #PvP great again.